or AWESOME Awards, as we've begun to call it, which is being launched to mark the 20th anniversary celebration of India's premier weekly magazine. You know, the aim is simple. It is really to recognize, to reward the outspoken, the outstanding, and the outliers of social media universe who've really added to the depth and the diversity of the discourse within their initiatives and interventions. The Outlook Social Media Awards, ladies and gentlemen, is India's first initiative by a mainstream media organization to honor the stars and the superstars of social media, companies, and brands, of course. Awesome, isn't it? So, to kickstart this evening, I'd like to call forward the CEO Outlook Group, Mr. Indraneel Roy.
Good evening, friends. Sorry to keep you waiting. We got a little late. You know, Outlook is a magazine which has been publishing since 1995. And in the last 22 years, we have always been a platform where we have allowed different opinions to be aired simultaneously on a platform which is pro and against. And that's predominantly what Outlook has always been cultivating as a magazine and has been developing it as a magazine. What we also realize is that a social media platform also allows you to post and create your opinions on whichever platform and wherever, whichever way you want to. And that gives us the synergy to actually launch the Outlook Social Media Awards. And you know, very, very, and we actually pronounce it as the AWESOME Awards because to make it a little cool. In this times of, you know, fake news, bots, you know, things like, you know, WikiLeaks, et cetera, leaks, et cetera, you know, what is definitely an important element is that how do we give the positive use of the medium and highlight it to the entire millions and billions of people who are following social media. And that's the premise on which we build the Outlook Social Media Awards. Our sponsor, PCJ, has been very kind to sort of support us on this endeavor, and therefore we call it the PCJ AWESOME Awards. There are 15 categories in this award, and in these 15 categories, the jury just met a while back. They looked at the nominations, they had certain suggestions, they have given the recommendations. We are still waiting for public voting to continue. We want 50% of the weightage is with the jury and 50% is with the public. So we don't know what are going to be the final results, but the results will be out and the event is going to be held on 20th of April at New Delhi at the Hyatt Regency. The jury is led by Mrs. Twinkle Khanna, and then we had other prominent members, Poonam Mahajan, she's not here with us today. Hansal Mehta, unfortunately he missed his flight, so he's also not here with us. Gulpanag, Tanmay Bhatt, Jose, Ms. Malini Agarwal, and Vaibhav Vishal. I thank all of you for being here today, and we take up to the next press part. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Roy, for setting the tone for this evening. Well, I'd now like to call forward the COO PCJ, Mr. R.K. Sharma, to please address us.
Good evening, everyone. The organizing these AWESOME Awards is a really very good initiative. We all know about the power of social media nowadays. It can make presidents, it can make prime ministers, and it has very large impact on even media marketing. The persons, our heroes, our superheroes who are actively contributing on social media, they are opinion makers, they are creating awareness, they are creating ideas, but also to others. Secondly, if we see this initiative has been taken by Outlook magazine, which is a well established for last 22 years, very recognized and with high credibility. So it adds more, you know, media marketing has changed a lot. earlier ways and means of media end user of the product. So communication marketing is very much important these days. Being PC jeweler,
I'd like to introduce you formally to all of them. Of course, we have thus our jury chair, someone who's true to her words, absolutely not afraid to take on anyone. Mrs. Funnybones absolutely lives up to her name. Apart from being one of India's best-selling writers, the former actor now follows her passion for interior designing, as all of us know, but of course not without taking... And we have with us the absolutely gorgeous lady who, after being crowned Miss India, has done everything right from getting a pilot e-car on a racetrack. She breaks stereotypes every single day on social media, promotes fashion, fitness, and social causes. Let's put our hands together for Gulpanag. And we have with us, right besides her, former RJ and VJ, who broke the internet with his hilarious but crisply shot videos, I must say. And of course, he's also known for his podcast, which is titled Khan Masti with comedian Suresh Menon, a compilation of very funny, provocative snippets from conversations between co-workers at a radio station. Let's give it up for Jose Covaco. And we're also joined this evening by India's most successful blogger, who is a digital influencer, an entrepreneur, a best-selling author. This year, in fact, she's even listed among the prestigious Forbes India W Power Trailblazers. And her book titled To the Moon, How I Blogged My Way to Bollywood, is really an inspiration. Malini Agarwal. And we're also joined by the of nosurnamefame.com, Mr. Vishal, Vaibhav Vishal. And with that, Vaibhav, over to you, sir.
Thank you, Xenia. Is this working? Yeah. Clearly, I'm the only one who needed an introduction. You know, I'm sitting with such luminaries, such social media luminaries. I almost feel like a commoner in the big boss house, you know, so I can empathize with how those people must be feeling, you know. But I do know Malini from before. Malini was my colleague at MTV, and she was a permanent source of cool for all of us over there. She was also my first commissioning editor. She gave me my first, I don't know how proud she is, but yeah, my first writing job was given by her. My little claim to fame, other little claim to fame is that I hired Jose at MTV, and I could not hire Tanmay Bhatt at MTV. And look how beautifully it turned out for both of them. You know, Gul, of course, I know as an activist and an actor. But the most connect that I have with anybody in this on the stage is you, Twinkle. I watched Mela twice. I paid for the tickets. Only a true fan would do that, you know. Yeah, that was me trying to, you know, play a troll over here. And the topic for discussion, you know, that we thought of today on the stage was the kind of impact and role, you know, the trolls have on social media. And these guys are dadas, you know, at what they do. You know, they deal with trolls on a daily basis. So I just thought that it'll be best to, you know, listen in, you know, about how to deal with them from the people, you know, who do know a thing or two about that. The anonymity of social media, you know, because you're sitting in the cool confines of your room, sometimes you don't have a name also attached to you. AC chal rahi hai, you're getting localized, conditioned air. Mama aake paratha de rahi hai. So all of this adds to a lot of, you know, bravado, you know, that you have. And then you become this warrior. Phir aapko lagta aap Dara Singh ko aap tod sakte ho. You know, but that's what social media does to you. That's what, you know, the anonymity of social media does to you. Now, this can have two broad impacts. One is, you can, you know, take it very, very positively. You can become a Pratik Sena or a Meghnad, you know, some people who are, you know, part of our nominees list and who are doing some great work, you know, taking on people, you know. But if it is left unchecked, it can have an extremely sad impact. It can make you into a very negative person, you know. And you know, the problem with that is that you end up becoming an irritating, offensive, provocative son of a, okay, whatever. And you know, and when his sole intent is to provoke others, is to elicit an emotional response from others. And again, you guys are more than used to it. So, Twinkle, you know, I'll actually start with you. You're funny, you're opinionated, you are a writer, you are a film actor, you have pronounced filmy affiliations, and you're a woman. Does it make you a living, breathing, moving bullseye for the trolls? What's your take on it?
I don't know if I'm a bullseye for trolls. They come along, and they do that to everybody. Yeah. And people who take trolls seriously, I would say, are rather foolish. I mean, they're like cockroaches. Once in a while, you spray hate, and they scamper out of your way, and you go on. But I do look at criticism, and I examine it very carefully. Sometimes it is valid, and it always tells me something about the world around me or myself. But I'm not going to really listen to somebody who can't even spell my name and calls me Twinkal. I really don't care what they say.
Okay, Gul, you know, I would love to hear from you. You, apart from, you know, being all that you are, and you're so many things, you know, I don't even know how do you manage to be so many things being one person. You also have pronounced political affiliations, yeah? Now, is the attack on you more, are the attacks on you more pronounced, more, you know, organized? How have you dealt with it? What do you want to say about that, you know?
I think the moment you take a position on anything, you set yourself up for an attack, either from people who disagree with you or people who just don't like the fact that you've taken a position. Because traditionally, women, and more so those who belong, so to speak, to the film industry, are not entitled to have an opinion. And that's something that's discouraged. It's changing now, but that was something that was discouraged even within the industry. As a result of which, what one sees is that the moment you've taken a position, you're going to have a bunch of people disagree with you.
Sure.
Some people will disagree with you in a manner which is probably fact-based or has a certain argument or two, which is, like just Twinkal rightly said, is worth examining and seeing that maybe your own argument in this particular case is flawed. But some people are out there just to get after you. Now, there's a couple categories. One is the ones who can't spell your name right. That's the kinds you don't engage with. Two is the kind who hurl abuse at you and physical harm at you. I've had people threaten the vilest things, threaten me with the vilest things, my father, who's also very, very outspoken, him, my brother. Again, all of us are very, very outspoken, with very strong views on things. So the trick, in my opinion, is to have a thick skin. Many years ago, I would let a lot of people get under my skin, a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I take things in my stride. I believe that is, having people come at you because of your views is something that's going to happen anyway.
Sure.
The important thing is to reserve the right to examine yourself and see whether you could perhaps take a better position. And the other thing is never, ever, ever lose your cool. Because too many of us have lost the moral high ground when we've resulted in or reduced ourselves to the troll's vocabulary.
Mm-hmm.
So I always choose the charming route. No matter how much somebody will abuse me, I will at best say, you're very well brought up. But I will never abuse online. I will never let go of the moral high ground and give and cede that to the troll. And I think that's the only way you're able to slay them with a bit of charm and some borrowed wit, which, of course, one would find in ample on Twinkal's timeline. So I think that's the way forward. They are going to be there. They aren't going to run away.
True.
And there are organized attacks, especially when... So there's something... has something to do with your political affiliations, of course, but it also has something to do with you taking a position which is contrary to the majoritarian one. And then the bugle is sounded and they come and hunt you in packs. So the hounds come and they come and hunt you in packs. So I think you've just got to be aware that these are hounds that are hunting. You've got to be the fox and not maneuver them.
But in some cases, you know, it becomes slightly scary. So there's this quaint journalist who wrote a piece on the entire Facebook event that they wanted to do, where the Bolna auntie Aunkya, that Om Prakash Mishra, the singer, people wanted to come gather at a place, and you know. So she wrote against it. She said that it was a misogynistic song, and the man has, you know, he should not be promoted. He should not be encouraged. And they, you know, gathered at various Facebook forums, and then they decided to give it back to her. gave her rape threats, gave her death threats, and it became a, you know, they had to file a police case and all, you know. So it ceased to be just one guy trying to act cocky with you, a guy trying to act smart with you. It, you know, it kind of translated into something really, really sad, you know, because, and they took her picture, morphed her, and, you know, you started using, you know, her own social media. So she went through a huge, you know, huge, you know, issue, you know. Sorry.
I think that is a lacuna. Mm-hmm. In the way social media platforms function, because typically this kind of abuse is aggregated on mediums like Twitter and Facebook, and more often than not, the position taken by the platforms is that you have to take a long, arduous route via the cyber cell and register complaints and deal with it the way the law would have you deal with it. So the fact is that we live in a real world. When you're putting yourself out there, you have to be prepared for people who are not going to say flattering things. And I just want to open the conversation up a little bit from trolls specifically to anybody saying things to you that are unkind or unpleasant. And a lot of famous people have actually left Twitter because In the past, we've had a sort of interaction which was tempered and filtered. So publicists helped you make sure that there weren't too many acrimonious or anti-pieces written about you and everything was in a controlled environment. Here comes social media where it sort of democratized the ability to have a conversation and say things about you. And suddenly you do get your bookies, but you also get a significant number of brickbats. Now coming back to being a woman in social media, there are going to be people who will say stuff to you. There's no getting away from that. And I think you've got to, I don't want to use the word toughen up, but you've got to have the ability to dismiss and discount. And when there is serious bodily harm intended or threatened, then you have to have what it takes to take the fight to its logical conclusion. And that's where a lot of us give up. Because the process of going to a police station, registering an FIR is arduous. And our law enforcement mechanism isn't the easiest to deal with. So if anybody who's ever gone into a police station, try and get an FIR registered, even for a phone that's been taken from your hands. I think I'm dominating and monopolizing the mic. I have to let go in a second. But we don't see these things through. Sure. And because we don't see these things through, we don't have very many people actually being deterred by it. So today, anybody can hurl abuses and bodily harm and threats and threats of rape and the like and get away with it because no one has the intent to go follow the course, go to the cop station, get it done, be like, yeah, you know, it's so inconvenient, let me block him. So I think therein lies half of the problem.
Sure.
So you've got to discount some, and then if you really feel threatened, you've got to go out there and make sure that you get this guy.
Sure, sure.